7, left foot, we have 1, 2, run it back, 3, and 4, twist 5, and 6, 7, and 8, and 1, down 2.
When I was a child growing up, I remember when I was 4 years old sitting on the couch with my parents watching Singing in the Rain on TV and just watching Gene Kelly just have a great time. And I remember being that at that age, being in the living room saying, I want to do that. I grew up loving basketball, and when I heard about these auditions for dancers, cheerleaders to perform at the games, I went down there. But little did I know there were going to be close to 500 girls also deciding to do the same thing. And when I went down there, I saw these girls and I said, no. I turned around and started walking out of the building. And I thought, I'm gonna go watch at least. I went back and I started watching. I thought, what the heck, I'm gonna go and try it. Just for self-satisfaction. And it's a great thing that I did because I did get selected amongst 12 girls to be on this team. The woman in charge knew of my choreography, my dance background, and she allowed me to take over and start doing the choreography. It was the perfect outlet for me to just experiment with different ideas that I had. Little did I know that it was going to become a career for me. So one game in particular, the Jackson brothers were sitting on the forum floor, the seats there, and they inquired about who's the girl who choreographed the Laker girls, and I was introduced to them, and that's when they asked me if I'd be interested in doing some choreography for them for their first video off the Victory album called Torture. And I just was blown away. Towards the end of the season, another season ticket holder and executive at A&M Records approached me and said, I love what you do with the Laker girls. I want you to put that style on an artist that we have, and her name is Janet Jackson. All of a sudden, I was choreographer, and the work just was a snowball effect from after Janet working with ZZ Top and then Duran Duran, INXS, the Pointer Sisters. It was going on. Luther Vandross, George Michael. I was shocked. It was like nonstop for me. It was nonstop, and it was at a time where I didn't have any representation. I had no agent, I had no manager. So my mom's name was listed in the telephone book. So my mom would get phone calls, and my mom would call me up saying, Paula, Paramount Pictures is on the line, and they're asking me what your rates are. What do you want me to tell them? And I was telling my mom, just pretend you're my agent. I don't know, just make up something. And that's exactly how it was, because it was a crazy time, but it was wonderful. And when it started proving to be successful for me, I really stayed focused in that area. But deep down inside, in the back of my mind, I knew that this was an avenue for me to do other things as well. And I always had the desire and the dream to be on stage performing myself. Knocked Out was my first video. It was also the very first song I recorded in the studio. And Knocked Out, I had recorded one song, Knocked Out. Then I had to take some time off because I had choreography commitments to the Tracy Ullman Show, to the George Michael's Faith Tour, and to the movie Coming to America. It was murder for me because I was doing all my choreography projects during the day from 6 a.m. constantly working, and then at nighttime I'd have like an hour dinner break, and then I would record in the evening till about 3 o'clock in the morning. So it was a very hectic time for me, but that's what I was up against when this all happened for me. So Knocked Out was like the start of something that I did not expect. Way You Love Me, that was my first video that I worked with David Fincher. The two of us together have a really wonderful chemistry. I trust him very much. He understands conceptually what I want to put across. David came up with the idea of using a lot of product shots and incorporating that as the opposition of what I'm trying to sing about, you know, showing that it's not the material things, it's the way that you love me.
Honey, I ain't impressed with your material things.
What's really great about Straight Up is that it already reached the top 20 on the US Billboard charts, and we hadn't even had a video yet. I asked Arsenio if he'd make an appearance in my video. He's a real dear friend of mine, and this was right at the time when he was starting his show. And he was very kind to come down and just make a cameo. And it basically, it was just improvised. You know, Arsenio got out there and was just acting crazy and started lip syncing to my song. And we just captured some real fun parts. David Fincher got some real fun parts with him on the video. When Straight Up first went number one, I was so sick in bed with 103 fever. And I mean, it was at the point where I was very run down and tired. And I remember the record company calling me up and saying, "You just received the number one record. You have the number one record in the country, Straight Up." And I could barely speak. I was going, "Oh my God, I'm so happy." Forever Your Girl, it's one of those videos that, I mean, that was a magical video for me because I got a chance to work with kids, and I love kids. I could be around kids 24 hours a day. They just have a way about lifting your spirits, and just their innocence and their candidness is just amazing. It was just one of those video shoots that went so quickly because half the time I didn't want to leave. If I had to go into makeup or hair to in between shots, I'd have the makeup and the hair people come out on the set because I just enjoyed watching the kids so much. They were so inventive and so creative. There are these two kids that auditioned for the Forever Your Girl video that just had me rolling, laughing hysterically, and had David laughing hysterically. They came in and they had this tap routine, and it's like, you know, that they rehearsed it 8 million times because it was just instilled in their brain, and the objective of this whole routine was who could tap faster than the other one. So it was just, they start out and they start getting really fast, and they have everything's going, the hands are going like this, they're popping up and down, and it's just the routine. And it was so funny because their taps would speed up and get all frantic. But they were the cutest things. I thought, we have to incorporate this into the video. One of the other kids that we hired, his name is Trevor, and he was the motorcycle dude from the Straight Up video, and he had the cigarettes rolled up, he had a little tattoo. It had a heart and it said Paula in it. And he was all of 7 years old. And he just followed me around. He followed me around all over the set. And then finally he got up enough nerve while we were having a lunch break. And he said, can I have your phone number? 7 years old. I said, Trevor, come on now. I'm a lot older than you. And he says, it's okay, I like older women.
Alright, Joy, ready? Okay, watch me this time. The step goes like this. And one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and eight. Here we go. Five, six, seven, you're on.
Hey, baby, you got to remember. Some
Bob Fosse had once made a comment about my choreography that was quoted in People magazine, saying that he admired my style as a young choreographer to have the ability to turn right when everyone is expecting me to turn left, and the unpredictable sense of my choreography he admired very much. When I'm doing my choreography, it happens at the strangest times. Sometimes it happens when I'm sleeping and I can dream a whole dance sequence, and I'll wake up in the morning and I'll write down things that I remember. It's really strange because I can visualize the whole thing and I try to remember it. It's frustrating because I wish I could wake up right in the middle of the dream. But a lot of my choreography comes in very small places, such as when I choreographed a couple of my videos. I did it in my bathroom, which I could only see from the waist up, so I never knew what I was doing from the waist down, but I got some of my best work done that way. And then there's times when I just need a real big open space. It's different for every project. It's important choreographically to be able to make changes. And from the straight up video to the Forever Your Girl video, those were complete changes. And now to Cold Hearted, it was another change. One of my favorite films was All That Jazz. And one of my favorite scenes was the scene called Erotica. This video was to pay tribute, pay an homage to Bob Fosse, as that is something that I thought that would be a change for me visually, and something that I really believed in, and I committed to it. The part in the video where I did the knee slide, the floor, this was done in an old ballroom. It wasn't a dance studio. This was done in an old ballroom, and because the floor was so sticky, we couldn't get that, you know, that slickness. We'd have to mop down the floor with soapy water. And like literally seconds right after they mop, it was like, hurry, get in your marks, we gotta shoot that knee slide. Before I could even get into the slide, my feet flew up underneath me and I was like airborne and smack right on my tailbone. It sent chills like up to my brain. It hurt so bad. But the only thing I could do was laugh because it was so embarrassing. And I was soaking wet, and we still had a shoot.
Ooh, really nice place.
Yeah, but places like this look great on film.
We're not shooting here, this is just a rehearsal.
So have you even seen this dance?
I haven't, but it's a Bob Fosse kind of thing. It's gonna be really, really hot.
Yeah, but tastefully. It's tastefully hot.
And hey, if there's any problem, we can always make changes.
Well, we're shooting tonight. This better be good.
Boy, it plays. He don't play by rules.
another look into his eyes and you will only see a reptile. You could find somebody better girl. He could only make you cry. You deserve somebody better girl. He's good cold as ice.
It's very nice.
We had a 23-person entourage with my tour. And when I say to all 23 people, we got along so great and loved each other so much. We all would go to dinner together. We all have lunch together. We all would go to see a movie together on our off days. And that was the camaraderie that we had that made it so special. And all of that just went onto the stage as well. Because when I hit the stage, there was nothing, there's no feeling like that when you go out there live. It takes a lot of determination, a lot of hard work, and it doesn't always happen immediately. And it takes a lot of hard knocks sometimes. I think the thing that really helped me along is that I always stayed true to my heart, what my heart told me to do. When I started with my choreography, I had the desire to mix technical training with street funk. People were laughing, oh yeah, that's not gonna work. But it's something that I believed in, and I thought the chemistry of the two would be a real nice mixture, and I believed in it. And I'm not saying that not to take the advice of other people who you very much look up to, because everyone's opinion is worth something, but you have to weigh it out and carefully measure it and basically mix it up with 90% of what you believe in yourself. And if you stay close to what you believe in, no one can take that away from you, and when the success does happen, you can always feel that it's something that I always believed in.
You.
And the winner is Paula Abdul for Velcro Fly by ZZ Top.
And the winner is...
Gosh, I don't want to offend anybody. Oh dear, I can remember giving this lady a award for best choreography, but not only has she danced her way to the top, she's done it with number one singles. It's Paula Abdul.
And the winner is... Who do you think it is? It's Paula Abdul.
And the winner...